We got here. Kobold. Quite a few. But one's already dead. Khalid lagging behind.
You've a thought?
She's out of bullets. Alright.
Nature as you direct. What is it?
There's a lot of them. How about a sleep spell? Awesome.
Butt kicking for goodness!
I am gonna leave the short swords. This is too many of them. Ooh, a lynx eye gem. A blue stone necklace. Awesome. How much money do we have now? Forget where it says. $548. Clean all that crap off there. Good thing we got rid of those kobolds. They were near those other tents. Back here. Alright, let's finish exploring. We should rest soon so Branwen has her spells and Jahira has her healing spells. That'd be a good thing. Nothing in these woods. I saved you, farmer, after stealing from you. Brenwyn says, oh, that's right, I forgot to talk to her. I must thank you again for rescuing me from that sorceress imprisonment. Although I confess it stings my pride to be rendered helpless in such a manner, Tempest has reminded me that all warriors need aid from comrades in arms occasionally. Oh, jeez. That's all right, Brenwyn. It was a pleasure. Not merely a pleasure on your part. Those skulls are not dropped by every gibberling and goblin, and they are worth goodly coin besides. You have sacrificed for me, and I shall sacrifice of my blood and sweat for you. Let's talk to her.
Hello. If Tempus wills it. What? Such menial tasks.
You look at the barbarian woman who fights with such vigor. She is calmer now, and somehow looks a little less stern. Perhaps now is a good time to ask about her past. Surely she has had some adventures, before she was turned into cold marble, that is. Can you restrain your battle cries once? You talk about Branwyn's problems and hopes in a friendly and kind manner, in hopes of making Branwyn confide in you. Bah! Talking does not help me to prove my worth to Tempest. Let me look at that gash on your cheek, Sapphire. It looks nasty. Does, huh? You are used to hearing things about from the bottom of people's hearts, so you try to charm Branwyn into telling you more about herself. Didn't work either. Ask her lots of personal questions. By Tempest's unshaven beard, leave me be with your questioning. Mm-hmm. You proceed with asking inquisitive questions about Branwyn's past. Nope. I don't need better charisma for this kind of stuff. Are you alright, Brenwyn? All is good and well. Should I take a look at your own wounds? I like your temper, Brenwyn. No, Sapphire. 'Tis yours which is a fine sight to behold. All right.
You point.
Butt kicking for goodness!
You point, I punch. Oh, we've explored almost all of it. Let's see if we can clear some of this off the middle. Clear it off. Got it. So, merchant, 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 merchant. Okay. That guy gonna freak on me if I still... Was he far enough away?
you want.
All right, all right.
Is it F5? Spears? I don't need those.
You need a new tailor. Your clothes are absolutely dreadful.
She closed my container. Or he did. Lord Binky the Buffoon says, "Oh, how dreadfully unposh you all are. I mean, honestly, this is a carnival, not a gladiator's ring." I'm all the way over here, but my name's Sapphire. What's yours? Mon namen est Sapphire. What is yours? Are you mocking me? Dost thou mockest me? Away with you, beggar. Unless you're glowing. Okay, we got more people around. Edward?
I've no time for to talk to you now.
Yes? A simple matter?
I can't talk to him?
You funny looking!
And this is all so exciting. Why can't I talk
to the
merchant?
Hey, how are things going?
That's odd, okay.
Let's talk more full plate and packing steel.
All my stuff is authentic. Really, it is.
He wouldn't talk to me. Jeez. He wouldn't talk to either of the two women. Got some kind of problem over there? Hey, sirs and madams, would you like to take a look at my wares? Surely every one of you has some children in the family, hmm? What would be better than a nice, small, nice pet as a present? See here, I have hamsters, rabbits. I'm talking about hamsters. We got the best hamster in the party already. Oh, so cute. Sapphire, look at those eyes. How can anyone resist? Minx knows that not everyone is as fortunate as him to have a miniature giant hamster as a friend. A normal hamster is better than nothing. Imoen says, oh, you think every one of us should have one. I'd love to have one. Sapphire, please? Please? Branwen says, these are meant as pets. There are families who could use a rabbit or two to lessen their hunger. Jahira says, it is against nature. Seeing these animals caged like this. Yes, my lovely pets are always an enjoyable sight. I beg your pardon. What am I supposed to do with a rodent? My animals are all healthy and young. Look at the fine fur. No, boy, you stay away from there. Edward says, I didn't touch anything. I was only looking. Do you think I am blind? I see your hands reaching out for one of the hamsters. I only want to pet them. They're so sweet. Keep your hands away from there. I wish Mommy would buy me a hamster. Humph. Childish children. Childish children is gonna... Okay. Don't own enough money, but want to have one of the pets. I have to fight at least one of them off every single moment. That boy is more persistent than the usual ones, though. Seems he would do a lot for a hamster. Well, no money, no hamster. It's as easy as that. But what do I see? You took a hamster. You're a thief. I didn't do such a thing, I swear. But here it is. I see it on your bulky Rashomon friend there. Now it went hiding in his clothes. That is a giant miniature hamster and belongs to my friend. I don't know what this is today. First that stupid boy, and now this. I will go and move my shop to a completely new place. This is the opportunity. I'll go to my friend's farm for a prize rabbit, and then it's on to Baldur's Gate. Out of my way. Whatever.
You funny looking.
Oh, what a pity. Now the vendor moved away. I guess I won't get a hamster from Uncle Sammy then. Do you have any idea where he went to? He says something about going north, and now he looks forward to staying in his favorite room in the Friendly Arm Inn for a while. I've never been to the Friendly Arm Inn. My mom won't let me go further than the Belching Dragon. You seem to want to have a hamster, pretty much. Yes, very much. I don't have the money, though. I guess I'm off to play, then.
You funny looking!
I wonder if that's a quest, but there's no quest update here. I think we've talked to him. I'm having trouble with the pathing here.
I've got the best prices this side of Cormyr.
Alright. Maybe these swords we can sell? Who took them? You got it. Okay. There's a gambling tent over here. This is another boy.
Cool one, sir.
Minsk is confused, Boo. Minsk has noticed. What is it? Minsk likes the company, but 8 paws are a bit much on Minsk's skin. You have 2 hamsters now? Haha, they are chasing each other now. Minsk, this is serious. So we did steal a hamster, like the vendor said. We have to give it back. Minsk likes this idea. Minsk will show Sapphire the hamster. Here. No, this is Boo. Wait, here. No, this is also Boo. Minsk, are you sure it's 2 hamsters? The hamster is very good at hiding. Minsk has to put this down, and this. No, Minsk, your armor stays on. Here it is. See? Now Sapphire can see the hamster. Jahira says, Sapphire, this is a female hamster. We should give it back soon, or there will be more. At least let us separate the two. Oh, can I take it? Emwin says. Minsk, you already have one. This is so unfair. No, this hamster will stay with Minsk. Jahira says, Minsk, be reasonable. If they both stay with you, we will soon have many little ones. Really? Oh, that would be fabulous, Emwin giggles. Emwin, I don't think you're aware of the scope of this. The hamster stays with Minsk until we find the Vendorman. Minsk will not give it to anybody else than the Vendorman. Boo wouldn't like it. Minsk somehow managed to keep a hamster from that pet vendor and refuses to get rid of it other than to give it back to him. I guess I have to search where that vendor has his whereabouts now. Alright. A friendly arm in. I guess if we wait too long, he'll be up in Baldur's Gate. It's going to take us a while to get there. Can't give it to Edward?
You funny looking!
That one is a grown one, isn't it? Well, that's the one we took accidentally from the vendor. Oh, it's so cute. Can I have it? Please? Please? No, little boy, Min says. Sapphire and I are looking for a vendor man to give back his hamster. The vendor said he wouldn't work as a vendor anymore. He said he'd go far away. You want to carry a hamster in your backpack while adventuring? And he's appealing to our sense of pragmatism here. Well, Min says. The boy has got a point. I know this is not what you wanted, Minsk, but the hamster will stay with the boy and spare us the hassle searching for that vendor. Ooh, thank you. Boo says it's not a bad idea. Searching for vendor man might be more difficult than it would be good for a little hamster. So Minsk agrees. I guess I'm off to play then. We did get rid of the second hamster. I hope Boo isn't too heartbroken. No experience for that or anything?
Mother said not to talk with strangers.
Papa was in the mines, but Mama says he's with the mommy of all now. The mommy of all. Okay, that's the gambling tent. Another gambling tent. Let's take a look around outside first.
Weather's been lousy lately.
Don't have time to talk to you now. I have my cattle to care for back at the farm. Before I go, you just take my advice. I'd watch yourself while traveling the roads. There'll be bandits in the wilderness who'll take more than just your gold. Yes, I'm aware of that. We've dispatched many of them. Very colorful insignia. Cover the rest of this, and then we'll head for the gambling tents. I will not be betting too much gold. Splitting up is never a good idea. Ah, we've got a tiny little bit over there. That's it. Well, I can go in this little tent.
Leave us alone, will you? Nothing for you here.
Zordral says, "You there, stay back. If any of you come any closer, I'll kill her. I'm serious. Don't make me do it. All I have to do is say the last word of my spell and she'll die." What's this all about? She's a witch. She'll use her magics to poison the children of this town. She'll butcher the livestock and she'll seduce the young men, make them her puppets. She must be killed. Why don't we discuss this like rational beings? Just calm down, and I'm sure we can come to some sane solution. Discuss? There was nothing to discuss. This witch will die. Now leave me, or I'll smite you as well. Come on, we can't just let you murder a defenseless woman. Just calm down and let's talk. Defenseless woman. She's a witch. She's dangerous and must be killed. Get away from me before I kill you all. Okay, that's it, you idiot. We've had it with your theatrics. If you were a real mage, by now you would have blasted us to pieces. Obviously, you're nothing but a fake, a fraud, a huckster. Are you mocking me? No one mocks the great Zordral. You will pay for your insolence.
You point, I punch.
Okay, punch here.
Go for the eyes, fool! Go for the eyes! Rask!
Okay, we are... Charmed? Some of us are. Or spooked.
What is it?
Magic missiles take him down. Ow. One more. Ooh, chunks.
This but a flesh wound.
8 acid damage. Okay. I don't have anyone who can cast anything. She's gonna be dead already. She just joined us. Panic and acid.
Omnipresent authority figure.
What?
Oh wait, I have a healing spell. Resist fear. Well, that would have helped. Wait, isn't it their special ability? Ah, crap. We'll have to go heal her.
Such menial tasks.
Mage robe. Huh. Since the age of Netherrealm, mages have learned to bestow a wide variety of magical properties upon the everyday objects that surround them. A favorite item of such enchantment is the common robe. It is lightweight, affordable, and holds its enchantment well, thereby making ideal equipment for a mage. Due to their magical heritage, however, only single, dual, and multi-class mages may wear these enchanted robes. Spell of armor, color spray, a quarterstaff, and 79 gold. What do we find here? History of Shadowdale 8. see if that's one of the ones I need.
Do you want to tell me a story about trollops and plugtails? Please? Good on you if you save the day.
Okay, Emmowyn. Oh, I have Shadowdale 8. But there's some other stuff. There's a throwing dagger. 20 gold. And a quarter staff. They sell for, like, nothing. 15 gold. Bentha?
Yes, friend?
Thank you for rescuing me. I am Bentha, and you could call me a witch, for I do use magic. However, I have no intentions of killing the livestock or seducing the young men. Zordral is an old enemy of mine, one who has caused me and my family great pain over the years. If you had not walked in at that moment, I would have been killed. I must thank you again. Is there anything I can do to help you? Yeah, raise our cleric for us, will you? Do you have any magic trinkets you can give us? Why, yes, I do. Here, take this. It might come in useful in times of need. It's a potion that cures all poisons. Okay, she's gone. Oh, that's the quarterstaff we don't need. Alright, we need to go raise her.
Less talk, more fight. Butt kicking for goodness!
Well, I feel we should raise her first before we do any gambling.
Cool butt kicking for goodness!
Good on you if you save the day.
If I had let her rest beforehand, plus we can go in some more tents. But let's, I don't know if there's going to be anything else going on. There's the mines.
Full plate and packing steel.
Yeah, we need to raise her first before we do anything else. I don't know if there's going to be any altercations in the other tents. And then we'll go back. You just joined our party and died already. Kind of depressing, isn't it?
Full plate and packing steel.
Helm, watch over thee upon thy quest.
Wow. Does it take up almost all our money? Damn. Was that the one we just...
Wheel gets the kick.
Oh, never mind.
Plate and packing steel.
Never mind. I thought it was the witch we just saw in that tent. Branwyn.
Full plate and packing steel.
Now we can't rest. Maybe we can give it a try at the inn if they're no longer fleeing us. That was expensive as hell. Nope. Never mind.
Full plate and packing steel.
Yeah, we're gonna be packing our sleeping bags. Maybe we can sleep at the carnival.
Full plate and packing steel.
You like to say that, don't you? Alright, let's see if we can sleep. There we go. Sweet. Well, we don't have a lot of money to gamble. There's merchants inside the tents then, I guess? Hello. Vitiere says, good day. Consider yourself victimized by Vitiere, master thief and pickpocket extraordinaire. No time to chat.
Hello, pal.
We'll get stuck.
We lost 100 gold?
No point. I punch.